If you've ever heard the nickname the Nature Boy, then the first name that probably springs to mind is Ric Flair. This is expected. Ric's been the Nature Boy for about 50 years and has achieved more in his career than most wrestlers could ever hope to come close to. But Flair wasn't the original Nature Boy. Before Ric Flair had even laced up a pair of boots, there was a different Nature Boy who was gracing the ring with his presence. His name was Buddy Rogers, and he was one of the greatest heels of the glory days of wrestling. Buddy is famed for his legendary rival with Lou Thesz, as well as being the first ever WWF champion, which you now know as the WWE title. Buddy Rogers was a big star of a pioneer era of wrestling that definitely doesn't get the respect and recognition it deserves, which is why I started this channel. Every now and then, I'll drop a video on modern affairs, but my main long-term focus is content about everything in wrestling from the ancient times to around about the year 2000. Buddy Rogers was there for the beginning of the televised era of wrestling. He was known for his flamboyant heel performance and allegedly behind the scenes rubbed other wrestlers the wrong way sometimes. Due to maybe ego or maybe having a certain arrogance to him, it didn't help his social standing that he just looked like an evil villain, but it definitely helped his career. I've mentioned Buddy previously in my Lou Thesz video, but definitely have more content to make about the original Nature Boy. Buddy had become the Nature Boy when he moved from the Texas Territory to the Columbus, Ohio Territory. It was here that Buddy Rogers would begin to bleach his hair blonde and refer to himself as the Nature Boy. He would also do a signature strut and invented a move called the figure four leg lock, which he would use to great effect as a heel. Does that sound like anyone we know? It's quite funny just how much Ric Flair borrowed from Buddy Rogers. It was during this image and persona change that promoter Jack Pfeffer would begin to refer to Buddy Rogers as Natural Guy. This evolved very quickly into Nature Boy and became Buddy's signature nickname. He would hold on to that nickname for years and make the name legendary. In the 60s, however, this momentum would begin to come to a halt for Buddy Rogers. Now in his 40s, Buddy would begin to deal with numerous health issues, including a mild heart attack in 1963 whilst working under Vince Sr. at the then WWWF. This would lead to Buddy Rogers putting Bruno Sammartino over in a 48-second match.
1963 World Championship Wrestling. Bruno Sammartino challenging the champion Buddy Rogers. Sammartino attacking from the opening bell. He's got Rogers in the air. Rogers in tremendous pain. Sammartino with a crushing bear hug. Now Sammartino rolling Rogers over his shoulder. He's got him in the backbreaker. Buddy Rogers is totally helpless, and it's all over. Sammartino wins in 55 seconds, a stunning defeat for Buddy Rogers.
A squash match that needed to be so short for fear that Buddy Rogers may have a heart attack if the match was to go any longer. This led to a long break from wrestling for the veteran Rogers. During this long break, a new Nature Boy inspired by Buddy would begin styling, profiling, and figure four leg locking anyone who got in his way. Buddy would make his return in the late 70s. Buddy Rogers was now in his 50s and therefore in the twilight days of his storied career. This was when he would cross paths with a young prodigy, Ric Flair. Flair himself was a man who had to overcome adversity and health issues to stay in the ring, having been in a horrific plane crash in 1975 that permanently injured his back and changed the way he wrestled from then on out. Buddy Rogers and Ric Flair would feud during their time in the Carolina Territories, where Buddy had mainly been managing young stars. During this run, due to the risk to Buddy's health, he was mostly booked in short matches or tag matches where he wouldn't have to do much and was also every now and then a special guest referee. He was the special referee at a match for the United States Championship between Ric Flair and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes at the Greensboro Coliseum on Sunday, June 17, 1979. Buddy Rogers at first was calling this match down the middle and was a very impartial referee, until unfortunately in frustration, Flair would get physical with Rogers, and Buddy Rogers would therefore punch Ric Flair before counting a quick three count for Dusty Rhodes to win the US title. However, this result would not stick. On the following week's television show, David Crockett announced to the audience that after reviewing the match, the decision needed to be reversed and the title given back to Flair because of Buddy Rogers interfering. Rogers would next appear for Jim Crockett Promotions on Worldwide Wrestling, where for weeks there'd been a build-up to a contest where the winner would win an expensive watch. Rich Landrum would build up to a special guest presenting the watch, giving clues and asking questions like, who invented the figure four leg lock? Who was the only man to hold both the NWA World title and the WWF title? The answer to both those questions was Buddy Rogers. Buddy would come out to present the prize before having some less than flattering things to say about the new Nature Boy, Ric Flair. He would tell everyone that Flair had stolen the Nature Boy nickname and that Flair didn't actually know how to apply the figure four leg lock. Absolutely scathing criticisms that insulted Ric Flair's honor. I mean, it wasn't like Rogers himself was massively original, having taken the name Buddy Rogers from a 1930s movie star, Charles Buddy Rogers. And some even dispute the idea that Buddy Rogers had invented the figure four leg lock, with some attributing its creation to Eddie Graham. Flair would come out in the WRL studios that hosted the Worldwide Wrestling Show and demonstrated the figure four leg lock on Len Denton on the studio floor, where he was then attacked by Buddy Rogers. At the time, Buddy Rogers was a bit of a face given his veteran status and place in the world of wrestling, and Flair was a heel due to many events preceding this. However, after this figure four demonstration and subsequent attack, Flair had become the babyface and Buddy Rogers the jealous heel veteran. Whilst attacking Flair, Buddy Rogers would criticize Rick's attempt at the figure four leg lock, claiming that Flair had done it on the wrong leg. This truly started their Nature Boy versus Nature Boy feud. During this time, Flair's popularity had begun to explode, and this was when Rogers really kicked it into high gear, managing heel wrestlers in his group, which was dubbed the Rogers Death Squad by Bill Apter, a magazine editor. During this run, Buddy Rogers would bandage up his ear and tell the fans to keep the noise level down. This was hilarious, and would keep the heat on him because it made the fans want to boo even louder. They would finally have a match on July 8th in which Flair would successfully defeat Buddy Rogers for the Nature Boy name. Flair would beat Rogers again on July 16th before finally returning the favor and letting Rogers beat him on November 22nd, 1979 in a bloody brawl, the highlights of which are still on YouTube and are unfortunately the only bits of footage from the Flair versus Buddy Rogers matches that I could find. Unfortunately back then, not every wrestling event was broadcast or televised, and finding old tapes is a tough one, which is why I've mostly used clips from their final match in this video. In the footage we have of the last match, we can see that Buddy didn't beat Flair clean. There's a referee bump followed by Buddy putting what appears to be some type of brass knuckles on his fist and then going to town punching the hell out of Flair to secure the win. Looks like Rogers was also the original dirtiest player in the game. Through researching this video, I have seen so many similarities between Flair and Rogers and their respective Nature Boy gimmicks that it's pretty easy to say that Flair straight up copied Buddy Rogers. However, this wouldn't be a fair representation of the truth. Whilst Flair's gimmick may have lacked originality, there's a reason that Buddy Rogers chose to pass the torch way back then. It may be a little harder to picture now, due to Flair's age and also public image, but Ric Flair back then had it all. He was not only a promising young star, but the veterans could tell he had the potential to be the greatest of all time. Buddy Rogers having this feud with Flair was his way of passing the torch to Rick, and ending it with a brass knuckles heel spot was Buddy Rogers giving Flair some baby face shine and momentum, putting him over further in the eyes of the fans who would have felt that they'd just seen Ric Flair get robbed. And so we saw the end of the reign of the original Nature Boy and the true beginning of the Nature Boy we would all come to know and love. Just as an aside, Ric Flair is not the only wrestler inspired by Buddy Rogers to take on the Nature Boy gimmick. Buddy Landell would also use the gimmick. In the 1980s, including having a feud with Ric Flair, however, Buddy Landell's story is perhaps one for a different video. So that's pretty much how it went down. We went from one Nature Boy to another, just like that. I do wonder if anyone else is going to pick up the Nature Boy baton and run with it. Probably not, though. The concept is a little bit dated at this point, and was made so iconic with Ric Flair that now any attempt to recreate it would just be seen as copying, rightly or wrongly. You only have to look at the criticisms that someone like LA Knight gets for having similar mannerisms to stars of previous eras to know that inspiration is often seen as cheap imitation in the modern era. As always, I'd love to hear what you think of this. Who was the better Nature Boy in your opinion? Should Buddy Rogers have won that last match even if it wasn't won cleanly, or should he have put the young Flair over again? I've been Sarcastic Mark, and I really appreciate the support as of late, especially on these deep dives into wrestling history. More to come. Hope you have a lovely day.